Good morning. Welcome to you all to St. Giles Church this morning. Whether you are here in church or somewhere else, perhaps at home or on holiday, but able to tune in and follow us on the YouTube channel. We are live streaming service this morning, and we hope that we're more successful than last time. I think we've got the camera facing the right way, Nicole.
Oh, good. It was me last time.
So if we had the reverse camera on, it picks up the person sitting over there. So welcome to you all. And Catherine is with us this morning again. She'll be speaking to us a little bit later. Grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Hallelujah. We stand for our opening hymn. Love's redeeming work is done. Fought the fight, the battle. Jesus Christ, risen Master and triumphant Lord, we come to you in sorrow for our sins and confess to you our weakness and unbelief. We have lived by our own strength and not by the power of your resurrection. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. We have lived by the light of our own eyes, as faithless and not believing. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. We have lived for this world alone and doubted our home in heaven. In your mercy, forgive us.
Lord, hear us and help us.
May the God of love and power forgive us and free us from our sins, heal and strengthen us by his Spirit, and raise us to new life in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Continue by singing the glory.
So our first reading comes from Acts chapter 9. And there was at Joppa a disciple named Tabitha, which means Dorcas. She was full of good works and acts of charity. In those days she fell sick and died. And when they had washed her, they laid her in the upper room. Since Lydda was near Joppa, the disciples, hearing that Peter was there, sent two men to him, entreating him, "Please come to us without delay." So Peter rose and went with them. And when he had come, they took him to the upper room. All the widows stood beside him weeping, and showing tunics and other garments which Dorcas made while she was with them. But Peter put them all outside, and knelt down and prayed. Then turning to the body, he said, "Tabitha, rise." And she opened her eyes, and when she saw Peter, she sat up. And he gave her his hand and lifted her up. Then, calling the saints and widows, he presented her alive. And it became known throughout all Joppa. And many believed in the Lord. And he stayed in Joppa for many days with one Simon, a tanner. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Someday in the church's year, sometimes thought of as Sunday of the Good Shepherd. So we're going to stand and sing, "The Lord's My Shepherd, I'll Not Want. He makes me lie in pastures green." This is the modern tune we're singing.
May I speak in the name of the living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. In this gospel reading that we've just heard, we have a very clear setting of the scene. Jesus and his disciples are walking in Solomon's portico, which was a covered walkway in the temple. It was one of the few remaining parts of a very old temple, built 500 years previously. The current king, Herod the Great, has built a massive new temple, seriously impressive. But it is in the old bits that Jesus chooses to walk. And John says, with a wonderful eye to detail, it is winter. And here Jesus is confronted by some very angry Jews. They are, to put it mildly, pretty fed up with him. On the one hand, they can see that Jesus is clearly doing great things. But on the other hand, there are dangerous rumours about him, that he might be the Messiah. Now, that is a huge title with political meaning. And if he persists in acknowledging it, it could lead to trouble. Now, our younger daughter is now in her 30s. But I have a clear memory of when she was about 6 or 7. Being the youngest child, coming up to Christmas, she had an inkling that Father Christmas might not be real. Every time she asked, the rest of us gave her oblique answers. I mean, not lies, but we kept the door open just for this Christmas. And then just as we were going out for the evening, a few days before Christmas, this very direct little girl stood in front of us and said, "Okay, here is my question. Is Father Christmas real or not? And your answer has to be yes or no." So we had to say no. And the Jews in our story today confront Jesus in a similar way. "How long will you keep us in suspense? If you are the Messiah, will you tell us plainly?" They thought it was a yes-no question. They would be very pleased if he had outlined plans for overthrowing Rome, raising an army. He certainly was popular. Maybe he shouldn't be quite so free with the company he kept. But why wouldn't he give them a direct answer? You see, they lived in politically uncertain times. They could not see a way forward. How long would this painful mess continue? But just maybe, if Jesus was the Messiah, then things could improve. Now, it is obvious to us, and maybe doesn't need saying, but the times we are living through are challenging. We've had Brexit, overlaid by a pandemic, overlaid by a war in Ukraine, and it makes us anxious. It makes us fearful. We really do want answers, or at least some hint that God is in control. Now, what did Jesus say to the angry and frustrated Jews? He said, "I have told you, and you do not believe. What I'm doing in the Father's name shows you who I am, but you do not believe because you are not my sheep. My sheep hear my voice, and they know me, and they follow me." Now, the huge shift that people of Jesus' time had to make, and to a certain extent we all still do, was that he was introducing a radical new way of relating to God. Not rules, not systems, not armies, not books, or big solutions, but following a person. And although we know and believe that, it is sometimes not too obvious to us. Friends of mine who are not Christians tend to ask, "But what do you have to believe? What do you have to do? Why does God allow this mess?" And the answer is Jesus' answer. "Follow me. My sheep," he said, "hear my voice, and they know me, and they follow me." And Jesus went on to promise some wonderful things to his sheep. "I give them eternal life. Not they will hope for, but I give them eternal life, and they will never perish. And also, no one will snatch them out of my hand." Now, I think this goes some way to address our fear and uncertainty Jesus will not storm into a political arena and sort things out. He asks his sheep, his followers, to follow his way of unconditional love. When St. David, the patron saint of Wales, 7th century, was dying, he gave his followers some last advice. They stood eagerly around his bedside, wondering what he would say. What they were hoping for, a grand statement. What he said was, be joyful, keep the faith, and do the little things that you have heard and seen me do. Do the little things. Love your neighbour. Pray with determination. Give what you can to those in need. Make a difference. And trust. Trust the shepherd. Mother Teresa said that we cannot all do great things, but we can all do little things with great love. The Jews who encountered Jesus in Solomon's portico went away disappointed. They still didn't know if he was the Messiah. Following him was just too difficult. But for me, and millions of others, following Jesus is the only way.
We renew our faith and trust in Jesus Christ as we stand to say together the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit, and the great journey, and was made by him. For our sake he was crucified on the Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen.
We sit or kneel as we come into our time.
Let us pray. Loving Lord Jesus, we praise and thank you for your promise that as we, your sheep, listen to your voice and follow you, the Good Shepherd, and that as we follow you, nothing can snatch us out of your hand. Lord Jesus,
As we dwell on your actions on earth, we see in them love in operation, for God is love, and you and the Father are one. May we in turn union with you and put love into action in our own lives. Lord, in your mercy.
Yeah.
Father God, we thank you for all the blessings that you pour out on our church here in Codicote and on our local community. We praise and thank you for the outpouring of love and compassion shown towards the Ukrainian refugees as they arrive in our village. We give thanks also for those in Codicote and throughout the UK who are hosting Ukrainian families. And we pray, Lord Jesus, that you would be at the centre of each of these homes, filling them with the unity of the Spirit and transcending any cultural or linguistic barriers. We pray, Lord, for supernaturally fast emotional healing of the trauma experienced by all those who have fled war zones. We ask, Lord, for your protection and safety for all those left behind in Ukraine and for a swift reunion with their loved ones. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
God, our provider, in the light of the cost of living crisis and warnings of economic downturn, we bring before you all those who are struggling to pay bills and put food on the table. We pray, Lord, for provision for each one of them and increased generosity among those who have more than they need. We give thanks for the food banks throughout the UK, including Codicote's, and for all their dedicated volunteers. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you for the many charities that exist locally, nationally, and internationally, which offer a lifeline to so many in so many different ways. We ask, Lord, that you would bless each charitable organization with sufficient funding and voluntary manpower, including your church. We are aware that most charities are confronted by stark challenges, including the economic fallout from COVID, the climate crisis, and the war in Ukraine, all of which are combining to push countless more people into poverty. We pray, Lord, for all charities as they tackle inequality, strengthen people's voice, and confront abuse of power. Lord, in your mercy. Lord Jesus, giver of eternal life, we bring before you all who are mourning the passing of a loved one at this time, including Colin and family and friends of our dear Sandy. Strengthen, comfort, and heal us, Lord, and fill us with your peace. Lord, in your mercy. Risen Lord Jesus, we bring to you all those known to us who are suffering in mind, body, or spirit. In the silence, we lay before you those who have placed, you have placed on our hearts, who are in need of your healing touch. May each one know your constant loving presence with them, and may they receive your resurrection healing, comfort, and peace. Lord, in your mercy. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
As we recall how the risen Christ came to his disciples and comes to us today. risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." They were glad when they saw the Lord. Hallelujah. Peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us offer one another a sign of peace, friendship, and welcome in the name of Christ. Christ the Lord is risen again. Christ hath broken every chain. Hark, angelic voices cry, singing evermore on high. Hallelujah. Jesus came as your light. With signs of faith and words of hope, he touched untouchables with love and washed the guilty clean. This is his story.
This is our song. Hosanna in the highest.
crowds came out to see your son. Yet at the end they turned on him. On the night he was betrayed, he came to table with his friends to celebrate the freedom of your people. This is his story.
This is our song. Hosanna in the highest.
Jesus blessed you, Father, for the food. He took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and said, "This is my body, given for you all." Jesus then gave thanks for the wine. He took the cup, gave it, and said, "This is my blood, shed for you all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." This is our story.
This is our song. Hosanna in the highest.
Therefore, Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate the cross on which he died to set us free. Defying death, he rose again and is alive with you to plead for us and all the world. This is our story.
This is our song. Hosanna in the highest.
Send your spirit on us now, that by these gifts we may feed on Christ with open eyes and hearts on fire. May we and all who share this food offer ourselves to live for you and be welcomed at your feast in heaven, where all creation worships you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen.
Please sit or kneel as we continue. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Draw near with faith. Father, you gave your Son, Jesus Christ, to be the good shepherd, and in his love for us to lay down his life and rise again. Keep us always under his protection, and give us grace to follow in his steps, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Together we pray. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Stand for our final hymn, in heavenly love abiding, no change of conscience. God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, make you perfect in every good work to do his will. And the blessing of God Almighty, the loving Father, the living Son, and the life-giving Holy Spirit, be among you, all whom you love, and remain with you always.
Amen.
Notices to bring to attention. I'm sure you know this afternoon is our annual parochial church meeting, which we're looking to elect church wardens and further members to join the BCC. That's 3:30 this afternoon. It's also a chance just to reflect on where we are as a church and where we might be heading in the future. There'll be some tea and cake following the meeting. A nomination form, all sorts of papers at the back of church, but also be available at the meeting. Next Sunday, Wednesday, we've got evening prayer via Zoom, and if you have the email that comes out each week, you'll find the link to that. You'll join us time to time, 5:00 every Wednesday. Sunday next, we have baptism here. Now that's first for quite a long time. It's partly a reflection of COVID, of people not being able to gather, but now we're looking forward to celebrating with the Searle family, baptism of June. They live on the high street in Codicote. On Tuesday this week, we have a toddler tales at 9:30 for an hour, welcoming preschool age children and carers. Then Wednesday evening, it's a bit hot on the heels of the annual meeting, but it's the first meeting of the new PCC. We're scheduled for Wednesday at 7:45 in the parish centre. And then Thursday evening, those of you who joined in the Living in Love and Faith discussions during Lent, I invite you, if you wish to come look in more detail at some of the biblical texts that are brought into the debate, especially about same-sex relationships. That's 7:30 on Thursday. Two things for Christian Aid Week. So the end of the week, Friday 20th, Jill Pierce is coordinating Cape Jam Store. Jam? Yes? Desserts? Yes. On the green. Actual selling time is 2:30 to 4:00. We do need people to help set up from 2:00 and then to clear away from 4:00. So there is a sign-up sheet at the back of church that you can offer to help in a shift of maybe 30 minutes, 3/4 hour. And also if you can supply items to sell, all the proceeds will go to Christian Aid. And then also St. Mary's Welwyn is hosting a quiz on the preceding Saturday, the 14th of May. It's become away something of a landmark in the annual calendar, I think, at Welwyn. It is suggested you book, and people will be put onto tables for the quiz, and suggest a minimum donation of £10 per person. Not only have we got baptisms coming up, but we've also got marriages. So I'm now going to read some bans of marriage. I published bans of marriage between Matthew James Horsley and Emma Kathleen Mottram, both of the parish of St. Peter's in Buntingford, but with qualifying connection to this parish. This is the first time of asking if any of you know any reason in law why they may not marry each other. You are to declare it. Pray for Matthew and Emma in the weeks of preparation. Lord of love, we pray for Matt and Emma. Be with them in these weeks of preparation and on their wedding day itself. May they be sure of your love, their love for each other, and your love in their lives, throughout their marriage. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let you stand as we prepare to go out and serve. Refreshments over in the centre. Now go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.
Yeah.